Hey, everybody, NAMM 2020 Saturday in a very nice booth at the Fishman area here at NAMM. It's great. Thanks for having me. Ryan from Fishman. Marcin,
pleasure.
Nice to meet you. Marcin is a fantastic guitar player. Was on America's Got Talent all the way to the finals from Poland. Welcome. Glad you're here with us.
Thank you. I'm glad as well.
Before we get to you playing and telling us your story, let's talk about the pickup on this guitar because it's pretty special.
Yeah, no, we're really excited to have Marcin here because he's just the kind of player that makes this pickup shine. We've introduced the Power Tap pickup here at NAMM this year. And what the Power Tap is it's our rare earth pickup and our Matrix Infinity pickup coupled with a new body sensor called the Tap. And so we're calling it the Power Tap Earth, the Power Tap Infinity. And essentially what that is it's a small square body sensor that goes right underneath the bridge here on the inside of the guitar. And it really captures the whole top of the guitar. It makes the guitar come alive. You can hear all these dynamics, all these sort of ambient tactile things that you couldn't get otherwise. The beauty of it, there's been a lot of body sensors out there before, but the beauty of this one is it's very resistant to feedback. It'll take really high volume levels without feeding back. A lot of body sensors are prone to feedback, so we're excited about this one because you can get it so hot and you can get all this percussion out of it, and yet it's, you know, it really fights the feedback nicely. But even if you're not a percussive player, it still brings in this nice, you know, almost natural sound. It's like a microphone in that way where you can blend them together, but yeah, it's, you know, microphones are really hard to control. We have a rare earth mic blend, which we love, and it's great, but some players want something that's a little more subtle and just a little more easy and additive, and that's what the Tap brings us.
Nice. So now how did you hook up with Fishman and get this in on your guitar?
Right. So I've been playing with Fishman for quite a while now, but before, because obviously I'm a percussive guitarist, to get the balance between the strings, the percussion, the bass, and the treble, the whole basically orchestra of the guitar, I needed two different pickup sets. So I was just extremely surprised when Fishman came out with this rare earth power tap here, because basically I have only one output that goes out in stereo, and I can blend in anything that I want in the guitar really swiftly, and it just works amazingly. One thing that I did online was my own arrangement of Beethoven's Fifth Symphony, and that went pretty viral, going like 30 million views or more.
Congratulations.
Thank you, cheers. And that was one of the first videos I think I showed with this puppy right here, so yeah.
Fantastic.
Not with this one, but with the previous one. Now everything coming out from this point is just going to be purely one output, so swift and convenient, so yeah.
Awesome, and Marcin's gonna play a little guitar for us, right?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Okay. Let's do it. Marcin, that was really incredible to watch.
I appreciate it.
Just us here alone, hearing you play is fantastic.
Seriously.
So I got to ask a couple of maybe technical questions.
Yep.
Did you start in a flamenco Spanish style upbringing? Is that where you got your start?
That's how you know you're talking to a professional, because that's exactly what happened, actually, yes. No, I didn't go to flamenco immediately. When I was 10, I picked up a classical guitar and started playing classical music, eventually getting to the point where I was playing Paganini and then more advanced stuff. And then I met an amazing flamenco guitarist called Carlos Piñana, who's a professor at universities in Spain. And he offered me classes online through Skype, which was a great honor, you know, of him to offer that sort of thing. So I picked up flamenco guitar when I was 14, started blending the styles together, you know, using rasgueados and golpe and all of those Spanish techniques, eventually picking up a steel string guitar and building up percussively on that.
Beautiful. So, and I know you play a lot of modern music as well, not just classical things like that. So what inspires you in the modern world?
Yeah, so many people, obviously everybody knows me as a guitarist, and many people imagine that what guitarists do is only listen to guitar music, right? But to me, it's the absolute opposite, because I take all of my inspirations from genres that have nothing to do or very little to do with this sort of playing. You know, I listen to metal music, I listen to hip-hop music, you know, pop, electronic, jazz, and I very rarely do I listen to just solo guitar music, because I do not want to limit myself in a box where you just sort of just keep going with the same things. That's why I did arrangements of obviously Beethoven's Fifth Symphony, Toxicity by System of a Down, and Metallica, also did Paganini as well, Dr. Dre, but also many original tunes from me, which I'm very proud of. Together amassed all of my videos from the internet, got like around 120 million views, which is a mental number. And yeah, going forward, I'm looking forward to doing more originals, definitely mixing it with other genres of music, electronic stuff. It's, you know, it's all open, right?
Yeah. And you said you're only 19 years old, so the world is just starting for you, man. That's fantastic. Absolutely. And have you made any records yet?
Sorry?
Have you made any CDs, any records?
Yeah. Okay. Yep. When I was 16, I released my debut album called Hush. It's sort of it was a brand new thing for me. It was the first time I ever entered a studio, and I am very proud of what happened, because I started combining acoustic guitar and percussive guitar with electronic music and string arrangements. So there's a lot of influences there that aren't just purely acoustic music. You know, when you pick up the CD, when you listen to it, wherever, you can hear that there's a whole spectrum of sounds. Now I'm giving up to releasing way more things this year. I've met some amazing people who can help me out with that, so I know that this year is going to be very major for me.
And do you play electric guitar as well? Is that a stupid question?
No question, that's stupid. Come on, no. No, I do play electric guitar, but I don't do it like on concerts or on like official videos. It's more of a sort of fun thing for me. I love jazz music. You know, I studied jazz improvisation a lot, and it also helped me with my theory knowledge. When you arrange Beethoven, you know, and you try to transpose the whole orchestra and do all those things, it's good to have a grasp on that. So yeah, electric guitar, jazz, metal, definitely.
Fantastic. Now, how you all? You have all five fingers on your right hand.
Yep.
Have nails. He's rocking it out, man. How often do you have to make your nails? All the time.
Well, not all the time. Obviously, you can see that my left hand is sort of pure. Nothing crazy happening there. Everybody just asking about the nails, because what I do is I go to a beautician every month. It's pretty funny.
The reason I ask is because I was in a band called Spock's Beard, and our guitar player. Only used two fingers, but he didn't use a pick. He used his nails,
and he
had to go to a salon and get his nails done. So.
That's what I do. When I play electric guitar as well, I just use this as my pick. It's so natural, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
So I get them done, I have them done each month, and they're just so resistant, you know? You can hear that it's, you know, there's no way that it can break. I don't, like a sledgehammer wouldn't break them, so that's pretty important to me, yeah.
Now, do you go through guitars a lot? I mean, you're hitting it pretty hard. Yeah. Does it, I imagine damage doesn't really matter. It's all about the sound. How long have you had this guitar?
So it's actually funny. I've been endorsed by Ibanez for quite a while now, I think since the beginning of 2018. And one reason why I love these guitars is because they're really sturdy, you know? It's a spruced up. It really doesn't, you know, it takes a lot of a beating and you cannot see at all. However, the funny thing, you asked me when I got this guitar, I actually got it 3 days ago, because I didn't take my own guitar from Poland all the way here. Lots of hassle and you know, a new pickup, so why bother?
Yeah.
And the amazing guys at Fishman provided this beautiful Ibanez for me. And as you can see, I've been playing pretty hard on it, which you can tell by my fingers, for like 3 or 4 days now. And you can barely see a scratch, you know, so great guitars, yeah.
Perfect, man. Well, listen, it was a treat to hear you play.
You.
Congratulations on the America's Got Talent. I hope that does something. And best of luck to the future for you.
Cheers.
And man, come to Sweetwater. Visit us sometimes.
Absolutely.
We have a great relationship with Fishman and do a lot of business there. So come visit us anytime.
Awesome. Thanks for the invitation.
Thanks, man.
Thanks
nice
so
to meet
Pleasure.
You.
Definitely.
Thanks, everybody.